incarnate Son, the holy name of Jesus, to be the sign of our salvation. Plant in every heart, we pray, the love of him who is the Savior of the world, our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God in glory everlasting.
Amen.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God, for he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. For Zion's sake, I will not keep silent, and for Jerusalem's sake, I will not rest, until her vindication shines out like the dawn, and her salvation like a burning torch. The nation shall see your vindication, and all the kings your glory, and you shall be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will give you. You shall be a crown of beauty in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Galatians. Now, before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until the faith would be revealed. Therefore, the law was our disciplinarian until Christ came, so that we might be justified by faith. But now that faith has come, we are no longer subject to a disciplinarian. But when the fullness of time had come, God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me.' From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
In the name of the Savior of the world. Amen. Please be seated. Good morning and Happy New Year. As I said to my fellow biblical scholar, Susan Jackson, there were many options for church this Sunday. Only one of which is celebrating the Feast of the Holy Name, and as a scholar of biblical Hebrew, it draws me as a preacher today, but it's not in contrast whatsoever with our readings. In fact, I'd like to think that they're all kind of about the same thing, and those same things, I should say, two of them. One is, what do we name God, and how does God name us? Of course, we've heard a lot of these wonderful, wonderful names for God, and we've focused in this season of Christmas on the fragile infant birth, a fragile infant born to two parents who had absolutely nothing to offer except, of course, faith. I'm sorry, I'm fidgeting, but something fell off of this lectern. So when we listen carefully to the scripture we've heard today, it must sort of feel a bit like we've moved from lightning speed, from this fragile child in a manger, to an understanding of the Savior that is powerful, and more than just powerful, always present. This Gospel of John describes it in the following way: God with us always, the Word. So that is a name we have for God, one that doesn't come to mind immediately when we're thinking of an infant child in a manger, but there are so many others. We think of God as Emmanuel. We've heard it so many times in the last few weeks. God is a messenger. God, in fact, before God's people knew Christ, was too large to even have a name. And this is where the Hebrew scholar in me, if I can call myself that, I was a poor one, but an avid one, that I'm always reminded that the people of God, before Christ came along, felt God was far too powerful, too large, too beyond understanding, to have a name at all. They dared not speak the name of God. So it feels quite different to me to think about how we name God so quickly after the birth of Christ, and yet we do so in part because of the tradition of circumcision 8 days after the birth of Christ. And of course, then we also get this amazing reference we read today in Paul's letter about being children of God, that we are receiving an inheritance as, in effect, what we in this diocese like to think of as being siblings with one another and with Christ. What an amazing feeling of power when we have come in such a short time, in a way, from this place of a tiny, fragile child in a manger. And yet, that's how it works, isn't it? We are, on some days, focused on that tiny child, the idea of compassion, our own discipleship that follows in that way, the ability to notice those who, like Christ, are born into a world that feels unfriendly, antagonistic, and often inadequate. And on other days, we are those powerful Christians that understand that God is constantly with us, whether we think of that God as the Word, as Emmanuel, as the Messiah, as Jesus, the name that ultimately is given to the promised Messiah. So I think on this particular Sunday, when we have so many options, that what I'd like to suggest the church is calling us to do on this occasion, whether it's the first Sunday after Christmas, which it is, or whether it's the Feast of the Holy Name, which January the 1st always is, that we are asked to think about what is the name that we give to God. And if we truly believe, as I'm sure we all do, that it is the case, we are children of God, what more wonderful name could God give us? And what does that mean? It might mean different things to different people here seated today, and that's fine. But to me, being a child of God means that all that I need for protection, for love, for empowerment, if I may, is given to me by God. And it is this gift in the birth of Christ that makes that so clear. Paul also speaks about this as a gift of freedom. We are not slaves, but we are made free by this gift. But I'm giving all of these things my words, my names. What I think is the greatest gift of all, and perhaps particularly so in this tradition of the Episcopal Church, is that we are free to name God as we feel called. We are free to understand Christ's call to us in whatever way we discern. We are free, thanks be to God, to come together and to evolve as a community of faith and as disciples of Christ each and every day. So I think that, in fact, what we are acknowledging today is all of that, that Christ's birth gave us new freedom. Christ's birth gave us new life. And also demonstrated in all that he did and all that he said that the nature of God is love, and the context of our life, therefore, is God's love. So it is our job, not only in this season of Christmas, not only on the edge of this new year 2023, which we all hope, I think, will be one that is even more glorious than 2022, that we are Christ's disciples, free to follow, free to call him by his name, free to apply our life in the way that we understand God is calling us, and with our own special gifts and talents. So whether today we name God as an infant, whether today we name God as Emmanuel, whether we think of God as always present or newly born, In all of these ways, we are called, and we are called each with our special gifts to follow Christ in the best example that we know. Join in the words of the Nicene Creed.
What's the page number? What's that in the book?
358. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us read the Prayers of the People, Form 6, as found in your bulletin. In peace, we pray to you, Lord God. For all people in their daily life and work.
For our families, friends, and neighbors, and for those who are alone.
For this community, the nation, and the world.
For all who work. Justice, freedom, and peace.
For the just and proper use of your creation.
For the victims of hunger, fear, injustice, and oppression.
For all who are in danger, sorrow, or any kind of trouble.
For those who minister to the sick, the friendless, and the needy.
For the peace and unity of the Church of God.
For all who proclaim the gospel, and all who seek the truth.
For our presiding Bishop Michael and our bishops, and all bishops and other ministers, especially Meg.
For all who serve God and His church.
For the special needs and concerns of this congregation, especially for the selection of a priest in charge. Heavenly Father, you oversee all that we say and do. Guide the people of our church and the members of its vestry and its calling committee in the selection of our new priest, that we may be led by your Holy Spirit. Direct us towards the person you want to fulfill this role. Lead us to a person of integrity, a person of prayer, a person of faith, who is capable of carrying out your wishes for our future collectively. Above all, may your new leader be one who is willing to receive your unconditional love and pass it on to those who are near and far. We pray all of this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Hear us, Lord.
For your mercy is great.
We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life.
Especially for families and friends.
We will exalt you, O God, our God and King,
and praise your name forever and ever.
We pray for all who have died, that they may have a place in your eternal kingdom. Lord, let your loving kindness be upon them.
We put their trust in you.
We pray to you also for the forgiveness of our sins. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins, through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Morning again. Please be seated for a few announcements. The first of which is the Nicene Creed is in fact in your bulletin on page 6, David Harris. It just doesn't look like it does in the prayer book. Michael always does such an amazing job with the bulletin, but anyway, I just had to throw that little one in.
You just had to do that?
Yes.
The good news is we actually start interviewing for a priest in charge this week, so we ask your particular prayers for the calling committee. That's the good news. The bad news is there is no coffee hour today, but we will resume with children's church and coffee hour next week. I absolutely promise. Anybody else have anything they want to add? Okay.
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit was made perfect man of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. And said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace, and at the last day bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Evermore is to you, please. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
join together in the post-communion prayer found in our service leaflets on the back of the paper. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God, who sent his Son to take our nature upon him, bless you in this holy season, scatter the darkness of sin, and brighten your heart with the light of his holiness. And the blessing of God Almighty,